Using legendary weapons, was called upon to track down these villains and bring them to justice. They were the Trap Team.
What's happening, everyone? I'm Sir James from Gamerfuzion.com, and today I'm here to provide you with my review for Skylanders Trap Team. In this one, Chaos has blown up the walls of the feared Cloudcracker prison, which was holding up the most notorious villains in all of Skylands. Because of this blast, it pushed away our heroes known as the Trap Masters, along with fragments of crystals known as Traptanium, down to our world. So it is up to us, the Trap Masters, and the help of new allies and the new Traptanium, to go around the lands of Skylands to trap the villains and to defeat Chaos once again. As for the graphics, visually the game is really bright and colorful. You got some really nice level design, character models, and just overall details within the levels. You're going to be visiting some old levels that from past Skylanders game, along with some introduced new areas that we have yet to explore throughout this enormous land. Now, for me, I got the chance to actually check this out on current generation hardware, in this case the Xbox One. Reason why I bring that up is because I played all the other ones on last generation hardware, so going back and comparing it with the old one with the new hardware, I do notice a lot more visual improvement, such as making the images a lot more clear, a lot more detail within the models. Just overall, it looked really, really impressive. It was definitely built for current gen hardware. But even if you get it on last generation of hardware, the game is still going to look fine. Just my recommendation is current gen hardware. But overall, the visuals will look really nice. And of course, you have a lot of new character models, such as the new Trap Team and returning models as well. Now, as we get into the gameplay, if you're familiar with Skylanders, then the gameplay should be pretty much obvious as to what you can do. You can buy and gather majority of figurines. You can use your old figurines from all the previous Skylanders with the new one. However, you cannot use any of the new figurines on the old games. And pretty much you place them on the portal and you're able to use them within battle. You're able to level them up. You're able to take them to an upgrade chart, upgrade their skills and abilities, making them much more stronger than what they started off with. Now for this new one, obviously the new mechanic here is Traptanium, which are these crystals that come with your starter pack, the Dark Edition, or you could buy additional crystals depending on the location that you go to. Pretty much what you use with these is that every time you defeat an enemy unit, you're going to get the option to capture the villain into these crystals. Now what's nice about this is that when you do that, that crystal is pretty much a character and one of the cheaper ways of going about it, because it's pretty much more affordable. A crystal goes for about $6 a piece, depending on if you go to locations where there's a buy one get one for a dollar like Toys R Us normally does. So pretty much once you defeat an enemy unit, it's going to tell you what kind of element they are. You simply take that crystal, you place it into the trap, and now the enemy's going to get sucked out of the game into your world, into the trap. Now they're trapped inside the crystal. And what's another nice aspect about the crystals is that I was under the impression that you need like 40 something crystals to capture all the bad guys in Skylands. But in this case, you only need one crystal per element, because you can switch out whoever you want to use. Unless if you are the collector type of guy, then you can go and buy 40 crystals, which come in variations of looks and designs. But anyways, once you capture them, you simply put them back into the game, and now that bad guy is now a good guy, which is going to be very helpful, especially since, let's say, your Skylander is about to be defeated in a battle. You can simply switch out the characters, and you have a time limit of how long you could use the villain before they have to go back and rest. It's a really cool gimmick, and what's nice too is that they actually interact with the game. So let's say there's certain segments where it's like, oh, the villains are much stronger in this area, and you'll hear the villain, depending on who you have at the time, will be like, oh, you hear that? Put me in, and things like that, which I think is really, really cool. And of course, besides the main story, you also have little side activities that you can do. You have the return of the battle arena. You can go and collect all the different hats within the game. So there's obviously collectibles, just like all the previous Skylanders. You also have this chaos mode that you're able to participate in, which is kind of like a tower defense game, where there's this big old box that you have to protect, and Chaos is sending all his minions in to try to open up the box. And you can set up these little turrets and have a little defensive barrier, but it's just little mini activities activities that you can do to help level up your Skylanders, and of course, gather enough resources so you can buy upgrades. But other than that, the gameplay is very familiar besides the new mechanic, and even at the very end of the game, if you have the special Chaos Trap, which comes in the Dark Edition, or if you're lucky enough to find it in store, you could even capture Chaos and use him in the game, which is really, really cool. Now, as for the sound in the game, the soundtrack and the voice work is just really awesome for this title. You have the return of Chaos, and it's always fun to hear what Chaos is going to say next. You never get tired of Chaos. And of course, you have the sound designs of the different Skylanders, which just have a few different quotes. And of course, when you trap the enemies and how they continuously talk throughout your trap, interacting with the game was really enjoyable to listen to. And of course, the return of Kelly and Flynn and all the other familiar characters that we have seen throughout our course in time throughout the land of Skylanders. One of the other cool things that I liked is that certain villains, is that when you put them in the game, is that they have their own little personal music that they have. Like, there's this one villain that kind of looks like a giant piñata. Every time you put him in there, you have this little spicy music that kicks in. I was like, what? And I just, you know, I was just laughing out loud because it was really funny and entertaining, especially towards the very last level. There was some interesting music that kicks in, and even some familiar soundtrack pieces. I was like, wait, that's in here? That sounds really, really awesome. But once you get to the point, you're going to know what I'm talking about. And just overall, the sound work in this game is fantastic to listen to, from the soundtrack, the voice work, everything about it. As for the lifespan, overall this game has a really good lifespan, because not only do you have a brand new story, and just like any new Skylanders game where you can go and collect all the collectible hats, you have all the different challenge modes that you're able to do and try to earn a 3-star rank on each and every one of those missions in the game, especially if you're a trophy or an achievement hunter. Just overall, just many activities to do that's kind of going to prolong the lifespan, at least up until the next Skylanders game. And of course, especially for the collectors out there who are going to collect all the new Skylanders. Now, to be honest, what's nice about this one is that this is probably the most inexpensive Skylanders game due to the fact that there's not a whole lot of new characters besides the Trap Masters, of course, and some returning characters. But even if you're getting the crystals, I mean, you can choose to get all 40 something crystals, or you could just get one crystal per each. But just in terms of for the collectors, it's one of the easiest ones to collect. But for the players, I mean, it's something that's going to keep you wanting to come back to play more. And what's nice is picking out your favorite villains just to keep using in the game. Now, the villains don't level up or anything like that, which is unfortunate. And they even mention that the villains start talking like, man, I wish I can level up like you guys. But overall, it just has a really good lifespan, a lot of little activities that will keep you entertained. But overall, definitely something to keep you worthwhile. Now, as for the innovation here is the fact that you can take the Traptanium crystals and put them into your portal, and thus trapping the villains and reusing them into battle as an ally. But other than that, there's a lot of returning features that we've seen, a lot of improvements along the way, and the whole Traptanium process with the crystals is a really cool innovation, and I'm looking forward to see what they do with Skylanders in the next game. But overall, the game was really enjoyable, so much activity to do, and if you're a fan of the series, you will still enjoy this one, especially the story that goes along with it, some surprising twists and endings. But other than that, I'm going to be giving Skylanders Trap Team a 9 out of 10. If you guys would like to check out my full walkthrough, you guys could check out the link down below. Anyways, I'm Sir James from Gamerfuzion, and always remember guys, Gamerfuzion empowers your gaming.